somehow.
Just, yeah. I think she's gonna put something up. Somebody can see us, so somebody can hear us. If musical theater, tech week would be about a week.
What's that message?
Tonight it's 1 minute. She sees us. I think we're good to go.
All right. Is it 8?
Is it 8? 7:59, so I guess we'll wait a second. I see you too. Oh, we have folks watching.
Okay, here we are.
I think we're ready to roll. Okay, let's see what we got. We got 8 o'clock. Good evening, folks. Welcome to the Franklin Park Art Center's virtual coffee house. My name is Frank Shipp. This is my wife, Joan Wolford.
Frank and I want to thank you for tuning in and thank the folks at Franklin Park for inviting us to do this evening. We'd like to offer you a little sample of a musical we performed at Franklin Park 7 years ago called They're Playing Our Song. Two characters. We have been together for 7 years. Do the math. Guess what happened?
After the play was over.
The play is a fictionalized version of the 1970s collaboration and zany romance between composers Marvin Hamlisch and lyricist Carol Bayer Sager.
Together, these two wrote the music for the play with a book written by their friend and neighbor, Neil Simon. He got the inspiration for writing the book by watching these two in action. So, we're going to do it in the style of pretty much Reader's Theater. We'll throw in a little music along with it. But Reader's Theater has been one of our favorite things to do in the lobby at Franklin Park Sundays. So here we are Sunday again with some more Reader's Theater.
The original Broadway production opened in 1979 with Lucy Arnaz and Robert Klein in the roles of Vernon Gersh and Sonia Walsh. Our play opens in Vernon's New York high-rise apartment, adorned by his grand piano and the statuettes signifying the Grammy, Oscar, and Tony Awards that he won. The doorbell rings and Vernon answers.
Hello, Vernon Gersh.
Hi, I'm Sonia Walsh. I tried to time it just right, but I think I'm about 10 minutes early. I'm really so delighted.
Actually, you're 20 minutes late. But no problem. Can I take your coat?
I'm not wearing one. It's all part of the dress.
Very fashionable.
No, just thrifty. God, I can hardly catch my breath.
You didn't walk up, did you?
No, I'm just nervous. Didn't you notice when I shook your hand? It was a little clammy. Oh, my, not yours.
Did I do something to make you nervous?
Yeah, you won 2 Grammys and an Academy Award.
Oh, I'm sorry. Listen, would you like a drink, some coffee, Coke, or something like that?
I used to see a shrink in this building.
No kidding. Me too. And that's how I found this apartment.
Dr. Tannenbaum?
Dr. Markle.
Oh, I went to Tannenbaum.
He died last year. Tannenbaum.
I didn't know. Mm-hmm. If you went to his funeral, he probably would have charged you the hour. Hey, nice view of the park.
I never look. I'm afraid of heights.
14th floor a mistake?
Except I always wanted to live in this building, famous for musicians. Jerome Kern was one of the first tenants. Isaac Stern used to live here, Leonard Bernstein. And where do you live?
West 18th Street, famous for poverty. Mostly artists. They keep painting pictures in the halls. I can never find my door. I wish I could afford something like this. Do you enjoy having money? Am I too nosy?
No, you've been here almost 3 minutes. Well, of course I do, but not the money, but the things that come with it.
Well, I have all the things that don't come with it, and it stinks. Like having to buy my clothes secondhand. This is from the cherry orchard.
I don't know that store.
It's not a store. It's a play by Chekhov. My girlfriend wore it in the Brooklyn Academy production. It's practically new. She only wore it for 38 performances and 6 previews.
You're lucky they didn't go out on tour.
I got my eye on this terrific dress that's in Dracula. It's all white with tiny little black bats. Perfect for New Year's Eve. So how do you like the lyrics?
Lyrics?
You had them all weekend, didn't you read them?
Oh, yes, for a minute. I forgot why you were here. I was very involved with the Dracula dress. Listen, I have to be very honest with you. You don't look at all like what I expected.
Oh? What do I look like?
You're very pretty. I wasn't expecting someone very pretty.
Oh, well, you mean you found my lyrics unattractive?
I found them unhappy. A little sad. I expected someone very pale with a giant teardrop hanging from each eye.
When I write, it brings out my serious side. You'll notice I never wear anything from Hello Dolly.
I never thought pretty girls had major problems.
They do when they turn 40, for starters. Then I gave up smoking. And I just broke up with the fella that I've been living with. I call my mother, and before I can say hello, she says, "Are you still fat?" And I'm up to hock with my publisher for $800 because I went to Tiffany's and bought myself a ring to celebrate not committing suicide at turning 40, so I guess I write sad songs.
Well, they're damn good. I really like your lyrics.
Well, we're batting 1,000 then, because I really like your music.
Naturally, not all your lyrics.
Well, I wouldn't expect you to. I know how high your standards are. How many did you like?
One.
That many?
Part of just one.
I can live with that. Let me guess. Falling.
Yes. Well, obviously you know that's the best.
It's not the best, but it suits your style best.
Oh? You find my range somewhat limited?
Not at all. I think you have great range. Great unexplored range. Did that come out wrong?
Only if you happen to hear it.
What I mean is, well, what I think about your music is that it's so fundamentally basic. So intrinsically melodic. So universally embraced. God, I'm just trying not to say the word commercial.
But I take it you do want to write popular songs. I mean, we're not here to write the score for the Gulag Archipelago.
Oh, God, yes. I've only had one hit my whole life. That's why I want to write with you.
Good, because I've been working on a tune this morning. You might find it intrinsically melodic.
I heard something weird about you.
What?
Well, there was a rumor that you were engaged to 3 different girls last year. Any truth to it?
Yes.
Some people think everything is weird. If you're planning something new, I got this ring for sale.
Thank you. I buy them by the gross. Listen, some of these lyrics are very clever, very Dorothy Parker. I mean, Personally, I don't go for things like let's play two sets in Massachusetts, but I admire the skill.
I wrote that when I was 7. If you have a tune you wrote when you were 7, maybe you could do something with it?
Would you settle for a melody to Falling? I just finished it.
My God, you mean we wrote our first song together? I wish I had known. I would have dressed for the occasion.
No, the cherry orchard is just fine. Before I start, are you sure you don't want something to eat or something?
I wouldn't want to be indebted to you in case I don't like the music.
Listen, we better settle that right now. You have to be completely honest with me. I'm a mature person. I have an ego, but I can take criticism. If you don't like it, you must tell me. It won't happen with this song because this one's fabulous, but please feel free to speak up. Say, would you rather sit over there? I think you can hear better.
I don't listen with my ears.
You don't? You found some other interesting part of the body in which sound enters?
I listen here with the soul.
I see. Well, I don't have a big voice, so could you turn your soul this way, please? And this is very rough, you understand.
Well, I didn't expect to get on the charts by tonight. Down. the first thing that pops into my head is high school garbage. I don't know what the hell I'm doing in this business. I should be running a daycare or something.
You're not having a breakdown, are you? Tannenbaum is dead. Maybe you could go see Margo.
You mean you really like it? I have to know, Vernon, the truth.
Yes, I like it. I think it's a first-rate song.
Because I have such respect for your talent. That's why I was so nervous coming up here today. I put this dress on backwards. I don't know if you noticed.
Look, will you please stop telling me that I make you nervous? Because that makes me nervous. I'm just plain Vernon Gersh. I'm not Mozart, not Beethoven.
Oh, but you are. And how sweet that you don't realize how good you are. Your music is as important to your time as their music was to theirs. My God, you can't even sit in a dentist chair without hearing one of your songs. I think you're truly gifted. I think you are our only contemporary living American composer.
Well, thank you. That's very kind.
Well, maybe Stephen Sondheim.
Steve is good. I love Steve's work.
And if you say to me you don't want me to touch those lyrics, then I will not touch those lyrics.
Please don't touch those lyrics.
Well, then would you think about the first 8 bars of the music? Because somehow something just doesn't work for me. Oh God, I have to run. I don't know how to fix it. That's your department. Listen, I'm not going to tell Mozart or Beethoven how to write. I'm going to have all my hair cut off in an hour. You think I'm wrong? I trust your opinion. If you think I shouldn't have it all cut off, I'm not going to have it cut off.
At this moment, my feeling is cut off anything you want.
But I respect your advice. I really enjoyed this session. It was very productive. When do you think we can work again? I'm completely free and clear.
Well, we should get started soon. I promised Barbara we'd have 5 songs by the 18th.
No problem. I write quickly. Monday morning, 10 a.m. sharp?
Sharp it is. Meet me at my studio, 111 East 10th Street. It's more relaxing there. I'll see you Monday.
Oh, Monday's bad. Make it Tuesday.
All right. Tuesday at 10.
Make it 10:30.
Swell.
11's better.
I already changed it.
I'm going to the Hamptons for the weekend. Wow, this is really a great opportunity for me, Vernon. I thank God and our agents for putting us together. I'll make you proud of me. I swear, you inspire me like nobody I've ever worked with before. So, if you get those 8 bars fixed, you can call me at Gurney's Inn, East Hampton. You know, I think you can up the tempo a little, too. It's a little draggy. You'll work it out. Have a good weekend.
It's a little draggy. She's out of her mind. And that's the end of scene 1. So, later in the play, these two had fallen in love, moved in together, and then they saw their relationship begin to fall apart under the strain of competing egos. Things come to a head in a recording studio where Sonia is supposed to come in and sing one of the songs they've been working on. She has arrived late, as usual, leading to, well, they've agreed to break up.
I understand.
I'm sorry, Sonia.
What the hell? I'm sure we'll both get a couple good songs out of this. I'll get my things out tonight.
Oh, a package came for you from the Hannah Theater in Cleveland?
That'll be my gown from the Rocky Horror Show.
I will miss the Broadway melody in your closet. You still feel like cutting the demo? I've got the track all laid down. It's all set to go.
Sure. Why not? Might as well have a souvenir to take home.
I'll listen to it in the booth.
You're not leaving without saying goodbye, are you?
No. I will definitely say goodbye. That's a promise. advice on you. Thanks a lot. I'll see you around.
Yeah? When?
I don't know. I think I'm going to get out of New York for a while.
Well, try not to get lost.
Goodbye, Sonia.
Gee, you kept your promise. Goodbye, Vernon.
So, near the end of the play, our lovebirds reunite, and the play has the predictable happy ending as they fall into an embrace on the sofa. In real life, the songwriters later did actually break up for good, but they remained friends and continued to collaborate on music. And they left us with some memorable work. Joni's going to sing perhaps the best known of their songs for you now. Extra points if you like TV commercials or James Bond movies.
She later married Burt Bacharach, writing some popular classics with that great composer as well. So we'd like to close our little show with one of their songs, originally recorded by Dionne Warwick, along with Elton John, Stevie Wonder, and Gladys Knight.
Pretty good backup group.
It has a great message, one we hope helps find some comfort in the days to come. And I never thought I'd feel this way, and as far as
There you have it. Thank you all for tuning in and for supporting the arts through Franklin Park. That's what friends are for. And we look forward to seeing all of our friends again in person real soon, when conditions permit, so we can make more music together. Till then, please remember, no matter where we all are, somewhere, they're playing our song. For sure. Good night. Good health to you all.
Good night. Happy birthday, Mae.